Now let's get started with our next topic, that is the destructor. Now let's try to understand the definition of destructor. What is destructor and how it works? So destructor is a special type of member function of a class having name similar to a class name but starting with the tilde sign, for example tilde employee. So in the example shown, there is a class employee, and if I want to create a destructor for the employee class, as per the first point, the name of destructor will be same as the class name, but only difference is it will start with the tilde sign. So constructor is similar to same as the class name, and destructor starts with the tilde sign followed by the class name. That is how the destructor is being created. So in order to create a destructor, you need to write a tilde sign followed by the class name. Next point is, destructor cannot have return type. Destructor cannot have a return type. What that mean? We cannot have void, int, string or any other return type here like other functions does. So we cannot have any return type while working with the destructor. So destructor cannot have the return type. The next point is, destructor cannot have the excess modifiers. Means while creating the destructor, you cannot write public, private, protected or internal access specifier along with the destructor. So whenever we'll be creating the destructor, we will not write any kind of access modifiers or specifiers along with it. Next point is, destructor cannot have parameters. So destructor cannot have any parameter. So the parameter will always be zero here whenever we'll be using the destructor. Next point is, destructor gets called automatically whenever the object of that class gets destroyed. Means constructor calls when the object being created and destructor gets called when the object is destroyed. So as soon as the objects of the class get destroyed, the destructor will get called. And whatever the finishing process is will be done inside the destructor. But by default, in C#, the automatic garbage collection is there. So there is no specific need of implementing the destructor. We can use the destructor for the unmanaged code if required, and then write down the code for clearing the memories inside the destructor. Next point is, destructor automatically called by garbage collector when the objects are no longer needed. Means whenever you are actually using the destructor, it is automatically called by the garbage collector concept in C#.NET, which is calling the destructor when the objects are no longer needed. So this is all about the understanding of the concept destructor. We'll implement the practical stuff for the destructor in our next session. Thank you.